డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ సార్వత్రిక విశ్వవిద్యాలయ విద్యార్థులకు స్వాగతం.
డియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్, టుడేస్ టాపిక్ ఇస్ అప్రోచెస్ టు మెజర్ ఆర్గనైజేషనల్ ఎఫెక్టివ్నెస్. దిస్ ఈస్ ఫర్ ఫైనల్ ఇయర్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎంబీఏ విత్ హెచ్ఆర్ యాజ్ అ స్పెషలైజేషన్. ఓకే, లెట్స్ ఫస్ట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ది టర్మ్ ఆర్గనైజేషనల్ ఎఫెక్టివ్నెస్. అండ్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద టైమ్స్ వీ గెట్ కన్ఫ్యూస్డ్ ఓవర్ ద టర్మ్స్ ఎఫిషియన్సీ అండ్ ఎఫెక్టివ్నెస్. సో వన్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ ఎఫిషియంట్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్ వెన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏబుల్ టు డెలివర్ రిజల్ట్స్ ఫర్ ఆల్ ఇట్స్ స్టేక్ హోల్డర్స్. వాట్ ఆర్ ద స్టేక్ హోల్డర్స్? ఫస్ట్ ఈజ్ ప్రమోటర్స్, so it has to earn profits for them. So employees, it has to be it has to give fair wages to employees. But organization has to sustain in a longer term, so it has to be effective also. So effectiveness comes from the core systems from the organization. So in a word, we can say all efficient organizations need not be effective organizations, but all effective organizations must be efficient organizations also. Ultimately, goal of effective organization is to sustain the efficiency over a period. But then let us understand what are the effectiveness flows from. One is clarity in the vision statement. So every organization will have a vision. So where we would like to be in 2020, where we would like to be 2025. So the vision of the promoters of the company or the established managing director or chairman has to be shared with employees, vision statement. Then it will enable the employees also to share the vision, combined vision. And it has to show the bright future for the company. Like we see, for example, so many companies like Reliance Industries or Google company. So we are able to see the vision for everybody. So how, where Google will be after 20 years, where Google will be after 40 years. So then aspirations need to be realistic. I have seen in a company where they have produced only 100 crores worth turnover in a year. So they were ambitious to produce 500 crores next year. It does not look to be realistic for the employees. So in that case, the employees get frustrated and effectiveness will not be achieved for the company. And every organization will have its culture and values. So every employee has to align himself with values and culture to take from efficient organization to effective organization. So first, then let us see what are the factors influencing the organizational effectiveness. There are internal factors as well as external factors. What are the internal factors? Internal factors are all systems: HR system, finance system, program management system, process management system. All these are internal systems. They impact, they have high impact on the organizational effectiveness. That is, unless these systems are well maintained, well documented, the effectiveness will not be brought in into the organization. Equally important are the external organization, political the systems and social systems, ecological systems. All this also will have a great impact on the effectiveness organization. For example, now you must have heard the famous case study, Zuwaari Chemicals. It was established in Goa and it ultimately it has to be closed because it has not taken the feelings of the residents nearby. So it was polluting the atmosphere. So finally, there was a political agitation. The company has to be closed because it did not maintain the process effluent treatment plants. So the ecological features, political features as well as the social features are also equally dominating how effectiveness should be maintained continuously. So then let us call approach system. So what is the approach is, we should have systems approach system. You know systems, the input, process, output. So whatever input you will give, it will be processed at the organization. Then again output, we can observe the effective outcomes. So what are the inputs for effectiveness improvement? One is organization design and organization structure. So organization structure must facilitate its employees to share their opinions, enable them to build good communication system. Normally, communication system we see only upward communication system, downward communication system. So, there should be a facilitator for lateral communication system also, so that the employees will have all these opinions shared with the employees, and that will improve the effectiveness. Process. So, once the systems are established, then the proper environment should be provided, then it will enable them to process, and outcomes will have individual expectations and goal attainments. So, once the goals of individuals are attained, ultimately goals of the company also are achieved. So, this is a systems approach for the organizational effectiveness improvement. So, then let us see the cycle, how the organizational effectiveness cycle is planned. First, it starts with strategic planning. So, the top management will plan the strategies, how to achieve the goal of the company. So, normally this is called maybe 1 year plan or 2 years plan or 5 years plan. Nowadays, every company is going with at least 5 years plan, so that it can be shared with the employees for effectiveness. Then out of the planning, then goals will be set for each and every manager and ultimately for each and every employee also. Goals are nothing but the shared vision of the planning. So, for example, now we plan from 100 crores to 200 crores for a company. So, where the growth will come and which employee has to produce more, which employee has to align with other team, and what the new products to be initiated. So, all these things will come up in the planning stage, and they also will be made as a goals for each and every manager. Then the goals cannot be achieved unless you allocate resources. So, resources have to be allocated for each employee or each section or each division of the company. For example, now you want make innovation in the refrigerator company or a refrigerator. So, we are seeing so many initiatives, so many new products coming up in the domestic sector, domestic consumer sector. So, unless R&D of the company is given resources, it cannot reach the its milestone. So, resources allocation is very important. And after the resources are allocated, then employees need to be trained, because in a process of efficiency to effectiveness, some of the skills may become obsolete. For example, today there is no role of a typist, there is no role of a steno in a company. So, what will happen to those typists and stenos who were recruited in hundreds in some companies? So, they have to be retrained, they have to be trained as computer operators, they have to be trained in other skills which will be useful to the company. So, once upon a time we used to have company vehicles and company drivers, now everything is outsourced. So, we do not find a job for a driver. So, driver has to be retrained in a shop floor as a mechanic or somebody else in order to protect his job. So, that many companies are doing it. So, this is training and development. Finally, after training and development, we get a feedback from the managers as to how the revised skills are being used to realize the goals, and ultimately plan of the company gets succeeded. I think you followed the cycle. So, cycle starts with the planning, and then goal setting, then resource allocation, then comes the training and development, then comes the feedback. Ultimately, again it goes to planning stage, that is, plan will be revised or plans will be revisited according to the feedback of the employee. So, we have come to up to the cycle stage, that we have come to know how the effectiveness can be brought in. So, what are the interventions normally organizations they use? One is there are 10 steps, 10 commandments normally we call. So, 10 steps. One is team building. So, nothing can be achieved by a single person. So, teamwork is nowadays recognized as the best tool in improving the effectiveness in any area. 1 plus 1 is equal to, normally we call 2, but in HR language we call 11. So, 1 plus 1 can become 11 provided the skill set of 1 and 2 combined, and they lead to a quantum growth in the skill profile. So, then the next commandment, second, is decision making. So, decision making is to be decentralized. Normally, we see in many companies, the bosses take decision and it will be thrusted upon the subordinates, you implement it. But if you are able to involve your employees in taking decisions, they own the job finally, they own the decision and implementation will become very easy. So, that will achieve for the best results for that particular organization. Third is we should build a robust performance management system. What is a robust performance appraisal system? So, wherein employee will be asked to set his own goals in consultation with his boss. So, when he is setting goals for himself, naturally he will try to own more those goals and will try to achieve it. But at the same time, manager has to see that goals are neither too harsh or neither too soft. Too soft means it is to be achieved. So, then once a robust performance appraisal system is maintained, the monthly review or quarterly review. So, based on the review, the strengths SWOT analysis will be taken, strength, weakness, opportunity, threat, and this will enable the employee to improve himself from time to time and it will help in improving the organization ultimately. So, because employee when produces from X to X plus Y, when his output increases from X to X plus Y, automatically the organization gets benefited. So, it will also move from X to X plus Y. So, then the process fourth step is a work process. So, work process need to be defined and you can see under the SPC mechanism, the work process will be displayed in all organizations at a specific places, where an employee can understand what is the process, where does he stand, what is his role and finally, how he can proceed by himself. Most important is another fifth one is change management. So, what is a constant? Nothing is constant in this world. We are able to see how TV 20 years back it was and how TV it is today and how the refrigerator was once 20 years back and how it is the refrigerator today. So, change is the only constant, that is change has to happen for the effectiveness of the organization. So, introducing change and also sustaining change is a very difficult task, because every human being will try to resist change in his job or in his role, because he thinks that he will be forced to learn new skills. So, he may think that he may become obsolete. So, he will try to resist all kinds of change. So, then we have to be very careful and we have to mentor the employee, see that the changes will ultimately bring more happiness for the employee as well as more growth to the company. When company grows, employee also can grow. Then important sixth one is the employee engagement activities. Employee engagement activities means employees have to be engaged continuously in productive ways, because whatever spare time employees will have, they will engage themselves in grapevine, that is rumor mongering, all these things. But if you are able to involve their energy, they are able to tap them in a proper way, then they can be like quality circles we can form, and we can form individual growth activities, and also we can plan month end meetings wherein employees will be asked to give their opinions and share their knowledge with other members. So, all these things will be part of employee engagement activities. These activities will enable the employee to align himself with the goals of the organization. Next is the knowledge management. So, every employee will have the knowledge, but when he is not able to find the proper forum to utilize his knowledge, so he will keep up to himself only. So, there is a duty of the manager to understand the knowledge potential of employee and will should try to use it according to the best needs of the organization. Most of the bosses what we have observed is they will not allow their subordinates energies or knowledge to come up in the organization, because they will think that they may become competitor for them, but it is not so. Ultimately, it benefits the manager as well as the organization. Then the morale of the organization also needs to be toned up every time. What is the morale? Morale sharply differs from motivation. Morale is overall atmosphere in the company. For example, in a company when company announces that we are going to fire 10% of the staff because company is not faring well. So, it ultimately brings down the morale of entire company, because you have not identified which 10%. So, every employee, if you have 1000 employees, all the 1000 will start feeling nervous, and every employee will start try to move and will try to exit from the company. So, in the process what will happen is, instead of cutting muscle, you will cut the body. So, ultimately organization will suffer very seriously. So, morale of the company has to be built very carefully. That is, morale can be built only through transparent work culture of the company. So, whatever management thinks about the strategies, it has to be shared in regular forums. That is why we establish communication forums in the company, wherein chief executive will be talking to the employees at least once in a month or at least once in a quarter. So, wherein he could try to share his vision from time to time, a change in products profile, change in organization's thinking, change in vision statement, all these things they will be more. And then last but not least is the communication skills improvement. So, communication skills are very, very important from the point of effectiveness improvement. And communication skills, I told you already, upward communication we very rarely see in any company. Upward communication means communication from employee to the management. We can see only one type of communication, that is downward. That is, whatever manager wants to say to the worker, that is only the will be thought as a communication in any company normally. But many progressive companies now, they have started building up upward communication also, because in the form of suggestion box, opinions box, or even nowadays now email culture has come. So, they can send emails directly to their CEO. There are many companies who have introduced they are sending mails to directly to the CEO or to the HR head of the company, wherein these opinions will be collected and corrective actions will be taken by the company during the course of time. So, this will enable the employees to build confidence in the company. So, organization is called effective only when its all its stakeholders are working vibrantly. So, vibrance comes only when every employee thinks that he is a part of the company. So, this comes up only when proper communication skills are placed or in place in the company. So, now so far we have discussed the organizational effectiveness, what is the approach, systems approach, and what is the cycle, and what are the interventions to tone up the organizational effectiveness. So, now let us discuss some of the benefits of organizational effectiveness, because it is very important to conclude how organizational effectiveness, why organizational effectiveness is important. First is it is a customer's praise. When an organization is effective, a customer feels very happy, because what customer wants from the company? His grievance need to be addressed, he want quality goods, he want right time at right place. So, when he is able to get everything from the company, so, he will be very happy. Once the customer is very happy, ultimately company will grow. And second is employees motivated, you will find motivated employees in the company. So, that is the biggest asset for the company. So, third is another important concern for all of us is profitability of the company will go up. Because when you have when you are finding all motivated employees and all your customers are happy, so it brings raining profits to the company. You can see many examples in the today's history when you are able to find a good company, so you will be very happy. For example, so, if you go to a bank, nobody cares you, then immediately you will cancel your account with the bank and come back. And if you are happy, then you will try to introduce some more of your friends, this bank is very good, so go and open your accounts with the bank. So, this is a small example as to how it makes miracles in the company's progress. Then the stability of the organization. There are organizations which are surviving for the more than 100 years, more than 200 years. So, stability comes only when organization is more effective, and internal support will be generated once you introduce all these interventions. And next comes the benefit is process improvement. So, process improvement takes place when good communication skills are between the employees. So, process improvement takes place, and next goals fulfillment will happen in a company in an effective organization when all these interventions are properly placed. And absenteeism will be very less in such companies, you can observe. So, because they will introduce various incentives, and you will feel like coming to the company every day. They will feel that they are losing something if they do not come to the company. So, we have seen many organizations recently also, you must have seen in the news that always survey will be made, what is the best organization to work with. They were told Accenture is one of the company and Google is another company. So, they are introducing various measures for making their employees happy and to continue to be happy with their companies. So, once they are happy, then goals fulfillment will be very easy. Once the goals are fulfilled by every employee, ultimately it helps the company. So, less absenteeism. Third and tenth one, last but not least, is the altruism at workplace. What is altruism? Altruism is helping each other. So, when employees help each other, so because every employee may not be expert in every area. So, X employee may be expert in computer skills, Y employee may be expert in some other job, hardware job. So, when they both together help each other, then the company stands to get benefited. So, this is how the organizational effectiveness has to be built in, and it has to be successfully nurtured, and it has to be placed properly, and every employee must have a forethought about how their organizations are taking care of their employees and how it happens everything. So, this is a short topic on the organizational approaches to measure organizational effectiveness. So, we have discussed so far what are the factors that influence organizational effectiveness, what are the benefits, and how approaches, what are the approaches to achieve the organizational effectiveness, how to measure them also. So, this is the I repeat this topic meant for final year students. So, all the best. If any questions are there, you can give it to university. Thank you. Wish you all the best.
మా కార్యక్రమాలపై మీ సూచనలు సలహాలు తెలియజేయండి. మీ సూచనలు సలహాలు తెలియజేయవలసిన మా చిరునామా డైరెక్టర్ ఆడియో విజువల్ ప్రొడక్షన్ అండ్ రీసెర్చ్ సెంటర్ డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ ఓపెన్ యూనివర్సిటీ ప్రొఫెసర్ జి రామరెడ్డి మార్క్ రోడ్ నంబర్ 46 జూబ్లీ హిల్స్ హైదరాబాద్ 500303